Buongiorno Olivia.
Buongiorno Giorgio, buongiorno a tutti, bentrovati. Grazie per avermi invitato a questo bel panel e avermi consentito di fare questa bella chiacchierata con il presidente dell'ENIT, che credo ci stia per raggiungere, corretto Giorgio?
Yes, we are waiting for Giorgio Palmucci.
We are waiting for him, yes.
Yes. And thank you, Olivia. Thank you for your support during this period. You are very well known, your face, especially during Sky TG.
Yes,
And
it has
it
been,
was very
yes.
important, your role during this period.
Thank you, Giorgio. Thank you so much. It was a very hard challenge, for every one of us. And it was, though, quite of an honor for me to be a journalist in this period. It was a big responsibility because, we hadn't got so much information. The information were not so clear, so it was a big duty and a big responsibility to try to make it a little bit more clear and try to gain the trust of the public and of our viewers. So it was a very hard period. But I know that it is also for all the tourism area, to the tourism sector, which was one of the most deeply hurt from the by the pandemia, by the coronavirus, sorry. And so it's very interesting to know by Giorgio Palmucci how they are going to face all this new area, no? This new important phase, because everyone is saying that it can be also an opportunity to grow, an opportunity to change, an opportunity to find new models. So it is very interesting to put together all this information, all these skills, all this very deep knowing of the sector, and trying to make it better. So
It's
yes.
correct. It's correct, Olivia. It's a very difficult moment, especially for tourism. And of course, our goal is we start in order to restart in a proper way. And of course, we need the support on a different level. Of course, Giorgio Palmucci, that we call our captain, is an important role as ENIT and AICA, is the Association of Confindustria Alberghi, in order to represent the role of tourism inside of economy, both in terms of GDP, but also in terms of the value of the asset of the hotels, because especially in this moment, it's very difficult to restart in this way. Now,
Can we,
just wait. Yes.
yes, for Giorgio, can we just underline and remind everyone that tourism is the 14% of the GDP, Italian GDP. So we're not talking about just not holiday and having a good time and having a break, but it's something really important. It's like the hardware of our country. It's super important. 14% of the GDP, 15% of the occupation of the workforce. So we're talking about something huge for Italy, and it's very important. Sorry, Giorgio. And it's very important that it can start again and get strong again. So it's an important panel to bring together all the actors, no, involved in this strategic sector, and yes, make it stronger.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely agree. This is the impact, the value on the GDP, but is only the direct value, because if we consider also indirect support of the value of tourism for the rest of the economy will be very important. You just can imagine this moment cities like Venice without tourists, and it's the same for other big cities as Florence and Milan, of course. Easy moment, but this is a is very. We understand the role, because without tourists, without people, every activities is very complicated. think about bars, think about restaurants, think about shops, and this is the situation right now.
And you know something, Giorgio, that according to a report that Giorgio Palmucci will tell us in all the details, we have an asset, a very important asset, which is the domestic tourism, no? Despite all the other countries, like despite Spain and Greece, which are countries in which tourism is very important, the Italian people want to go to Italy. A big percentage of Italian people, it's like the 40% of Italian people want to know better, like the Italian beauties. So that can be our asset in this very difficult moment, that we don't have the foreign tourism, or not in that big percentage as the past years, but Italian tourism can do a lot. So that's very important. It's a very important number, 40%, 40, I mean, it's a very important number.
This is a very good point, Olivia. Just if we compare our situation to Spain, for Spain, the international tourism is very important. Also for Italy is very important, but as you mentioned, it's a part of the tourism. And in this moment, of course, Italians could be is a wonderful solution. But as you know, today also is an important day because it's D-Day, means that borders are finally open. And I just discussed before with Michael Widman that will be in Florence this week. And this is a good sign. It means if countries like Germany and Austria and Switzerland as well and France, if they arrive during this season, will be very nice. And because we are checking, of course, the figure all days, and the signs, especially for tourist destination from lakes, sea and mountains, are not very good, but are very good sign. Especially in the last week, we saw the pickup of booking because people will start think about go to holiday, because after the long lockdown, we need to go to holiday, and this is what we need to do.
Absolutely. I absolutely agree. It's like, yes, a necessity. Listen, Giorgio, I think that we have a problem with the connection of Giorgio Palmucci. Maybe we can rearrange his speech later, or we can
yes,
do some,
we can, yes. Yes, what, we can what, do what like do that. Yes, we can do like that. Thank you. And sorry for that, but thank you for your compensation, because online is very nice, but I mean, in some case, we have technical issues, but
of course.
Maybe we can start with another important topic, is the connection between tourism and Made in Italy, because this was the first conference that we are working on, and this is very important, this connection, because when you think about Italy, you think about brand Italy, you think about fashion, you think about food, you think about design, you think about culture, you think about lifestyle. And during this period, we met very, very important people from Made in Italy, and we made some interviews with some of them, with our colleagues, Nils. And we start with Carlotta de Bevilacqua, with Artemide, CEO of Artemide, with Riccardo Illi, Polo del Gusto, with Enrico Bartolini, the 8 Michelin stars, and with Lamborghini, Katia Bassi. Buongiorno, Nils.
Buongiorno, Giorgio. How are you?
Fine. You?
Tutto bene. Benissimo. Una bella giornata, Città del Capo.
Also here in Milano, it's a wonderful day. Nils, how many people you met in this period? You made many interviews with important people.
Yeah, look, I think we had something like 37 so far, and that I think includes the four that we interviewed for today, Made in Italy. It's fascinating to hear the varying views, and I think we made a decision to carry on with the series, maybe not quite as frequent as we have done in the past, but we'll certainly carry on and do the PKF Hotel Experts in Conversation with series. But today we chatted to four extremely interesting people. My love for Italy has certainly increased over the last week when I had the opportunity to speak to those people. Whether it's Carlotta di Mellevecchia, or whether it is Enrico Bartolini, Riccardo Illy, and Katia Bassi of Lamborghini. It really, really was a great honor and pleasure to speak to those people. And we look forward to hearing them in the next few minutes. And maybe in between.